Davis! Ah, tips it.
Oh, he blocked that with authority. Kevin Knox to Julius Randle. Smith. Find to shoot. Scores from the post.
You feel that? I see the confidence building.
To Wade. Superman, Dwight Howard. 2 for 3 now here in the first.
I love the drive to the basket there. Instead of trying to go around or over, go through.
Dwight Howard, huge block.
Just erasing mistakes left and right.
Shot from the lane won't go to James. Davis. Here comes the screen. Too much contact and free throws coming.
Hey, look, sometimes you need to feel out your opponent. Let them know you're there. I'm okay with that early foul.
First one goes down. Goes 2 for 2 at the line. Jay, last few drafts, the Knicks have gone younger. What do you like about Kevin Knox and his raw potential?
His upside. He just turned 19 on August 11th of this past summer, and what he did in Summer League blew my mind. Was first-team All-NBA Summer League, averaged 24 points, shooting 47% from the field. This kid has every chance to be a star.
The screen sets him up for two.
The pro game has really come down to PNRs. Let's see how the defense adjusts.
Let's see what the Knicks can do here. Smith lets it fly from beyond the arc, buries it on the catch and shoot.
I mean, does he have eyes in the back of his head or what? I get paid money to watch and study this game daily. Even I didn't see that angle.
James to Howard. Here comes the screen. Oh, had him going there for a second. Nice pace, sets it up, and slams it down.
Oh, man, did you see that swiftness? He dunked that thing like a tennis ball.
It looked like that in his hand. Dennis Smith Jr. up against the 8-time All-Star. LeBron with it up top. Leads 3. And the finish, slam dunk. They have set the tone in this one.
I love when I see offenses come out in beast mode. You attack that paint, you get to the rim, inevitably the floor will open up for you to knock down some threes.
Smith with it up top. He'll run the offense. Screen coming. Bullock guarded by Howard. To Dennis Smith Jr. Runner's good there.
That's what I'm talking about, Ed. It's that simple. Put the ball in the bucket.
To Davis. Anthony Davis. 2 for 2. That's what you want.
Big shout out to the athletic trainer for this team. It's obvious you've been doing all the preparation required of your team in the weight room in the offseason. Flex on them a little bit.
In a flash, scores at the rim.
I don't know what halftime evaluation will be worse. The ankles or the bruised ego?
It's James controlling the offense to Anthony. Oh, he had him there for a second to James. Here comes the screen. From the painted area, won't go down.
And one of the most underrated things in this game is quick lateral speed. Good job by utilizing that speed and taking away the lane.
Gets a look, can't hit. Dwayne Wade. Oh, mistake there as the pass stolen by the Knicks. Tough-looking shot there. Still gets it to go down.
Let me tell you something that nobody will ever talk about. Did you see him slow down right before he was about to go up? That slow change of speed, that slight change, was just enough to throw the defender off.
Both coaches hitting the reset button. Fresh legs coming onto the floor.
Substitutions, New York. Subbing in.
Chance for LeBron James. Shot won't go. The follow won't go either. Kevin Knox. To Payton. Oh, good defense by the Lakers. They come away with the steal. Jay, Magic and Kobe each won 5 titles. How are you going to judge LeBron James' legacy in L.A.?
LeBron James wins 1 championship in L.A. That means he will set himself apart. He will have won 4 championships in 3 different cities. Now, that is polarizing for some fans. That still does not take away from the overall greatness and the legacy of LeBron James.
To Alonzo Trier. Kyle Kuzma sends it away. Couple of cracks at the line now.
It's still early, so no real impact on that call. But you know that they're going to call this one tight, so you might want to keep your hands out of his pocket.
First one, count it. Able to convert on both free throws. Los Angeles has the basketball. Kyle Kuzma, strong finish.
It's easy to become mesmerized when you watch a player who can create off the dribble. We call that dancing. When you allow a player to dance with that much space, that's Prob City.
Payton with the basketball. Down a point. The drive, right to the basket, knocks it down from mid-range.
Might have had an extra dribble or two there, but he got the shot he wanted.
LeBron into the front court, looking to make something happen. Perfect feed to set up the basket.
Well, when you play for each other and not just for yourself, that's when great things happen. You essentially lose yourself in what the team is trying to accomplish. It's called unselfish basketball, and there's nothing more beautiful than rewarding your teammate with a nice pass and letting them finish for 2 or 3 points.
JaVale McGee with the block. Rejected by McGee.
Ed, that's light work for a guy with his ability.
It's Kuzma. Oh, had him going there for a second. On a pass stolen by the Knicks. Trying to cash in, and he knocks it down, Jay.
2 points.
Across the timeline comes James. Shot clock off as they look for a go-ahead bucket. Down a point. Deep three at the buzzer. That misses with a second to go. We're through one here at Madison Square Garden with the Knicks on top. Jay and I back with more after this. It's NBA Thursday night on EA Sports. One quarter in the books, and Jay, naturally, both coaches wanted to get more stops. But boy, was that fun to watch.
I don't know if I'm watching an all-star game or a regular season game, because I'm telling you right now, Ed, if it was the regular season, which it is, by the way, you probably want to see some teams play some defense.
Wade to Davis. Ah, can't miss those. New York in control of the basketball. Alfred Payton guarded by Howard. To Marcus Morris. Here comes the screen.
Whoa, gets to the rim and they'll count the basket. Two steps or five steps, I don't know, Jay. It looked good.
Clearly not afraid of the spotlight here, because that was not an easy look.
Wade, guarded by Gibson. Dwayne Wade, he is shooting well. He's made two-thirds of his shots.
Oh, don't see the read, be the read.
Payton into the front court. His team up by one. To Taj Gibson. And the Lakers clear. Jay, last year the Lakers 35-47. What impact, obviously, will LeBron James have on this Lakers team and their record?
There's no doubt that I think the Lakers will get over 35 wins. Will they get over 50, though, is the major question. I don't see that happening, considering last year only two teams in the West, Golden State and Houston, had over 50 wins.
Oh, he had it. LeBron into the front court. Leads one to Davis. And it's Payton there for the rebound. Marcus Morris, strong finish.
You used to hear all these coaches talk about, we need players to run the floor. No, I don't need you to run the floor. I need you to run the floor with purpose. Those are two different things. When you run the floor in attack mode, that's when plays like this occur.
James, here against Taj Gibson. To Davis. Here comes the screen. James to Davis. Missed a wide open look. LeBron James, 4 out of 10.
This offseason, I heard so many voices, even that of the great Shaquille O'Neal, talking about how LBJ needed to cement his own legacy. Well, for LeBron, it's not about chasing external accolades. It's about hunting your own legacy, and that's to be the greatest of all time.
Lakers ball. Davis to James. Tough make through traffic.
Bread and butter. And there are a few that can do it better off the screen.
Now a whistle, and we'll get a timeout for the Knicks as they'll discuss matters in what's now a 3-point game. Both coaches dipping into their reserves. Changes coming onto the floor. Smith to Kevin Knox. Bullock defended by Howard. To Dennis Smith Jr. Has a look. Shot by Smith off the mark. James into the front court. Up by three. To Danny Green. Lakers down to 4 on the shot clock. Oh, he had him there for a second. Ah, that's a 24-second violation.
That's why a rim protector is a necessity in this game.
Kuzma to James. Rebound taken by the Knicks. Smith into the front court. Down three. Here we go. Count the basket at the rim.
Well, he finished strong because he was able to initiate the contact. When you initiate the contact first, you bounce off the defender, which balances you at the rim.
Mitchell Robinson pins it.
Just incredible timing on that swap.
Superman Dwight Howard. Terrific shooting. He's 4 for 5.
Old school equals high percentage.
Smith to Kevin Knox. Spinning shot won't fall. And draws the foul.
Aggressive play there, but you can't fault the defender for being up in the shooter. You need to contest shots, each and every one of them.
Kyle Kyle Kuzma, a couple of free throws on the way. A career 70% free throw shooter. First free throw is good. And gets both to drop at the line. Into the front court comes Smith. Down five. And a nice finish at the rim.
Not a Ferrari, definitely not a Lambo, but hey, get you from point A to point B.
To Kyle Kuzma. Caldwell Pope here against Taj Gibson. Cleans it up. Offensive board. Nice follow-up on the dunk there. AD, is he a new age big?
Easy answer is yes. He is Mr. Versatility. He can do everything on both the offensive and the defensive end. He can fight the post, battle for position. He can protect the rim. Plus, if you switch, he can guard guards on the perimeter. That's what you love about AD. You need something, he has an answer for you.
Going to launch beyond the arc. Gets it to go. Coach cannot be happy with that closeout.
But it was how he created the shot. As a defender, there's a tendency to stand up when you stare at the ball. Offensive player recognized that, continuously moved without the ball. Bang, that's how he set it up.
Caldwell Pope to James. Here comes the screen. Five on the shot clock. Caldwell Pope. Missed it. To Dennis Smith Jr. They go down low to Randall. And the rebound taken down by the Lakers. Anthony. To James. Oh, great pass. Setting up the basket.
I don't know if the scouting report has made its way out here yet, but if anything, it says you need to not let him get that close to the rim.
Smith now into the front court. Down four. Lakers have the rebound. James, pass to the rim. Smith to Marcus Morris. Big finish that time for Julius Randle.
I see the easy dunk, but what I don't see is energy. Scream, do something, get yourself emotionally involved in the game.
LeBron with it up top. Two-point advantage. The screen sets him up for two.
Attack mode isn't a switch that you can just turn on and off. He needs to do more of that. We need to see him penetrate, get into that lane, and create.
Smith with the basketball. He'll run the offense. Defense making the ball handler work. Dennis Smith Jr. Now 3 for 9.
Ooh, cool, calm, and collective. The three C's. His handles are effortless.
Now the Lakers gonna use a timeout as they'll make sure they're aligned here in a two-point basketball game. Time to adjust. Both coaches making changes on the floor.
Number 6, Alfred Payton.
Los Angeles, they have it. Kuzma picked up by Gibson.
Number 39, Dwight Howard.
From long range.
To number 67, Taj Gibson.
Kyle Kuzma is going to get a chance at three here. He's perfect from the line so far. And he connects on the first free throw. Down the second free throw. Three for three. Nice. Payton with the basketball. 5-point game. To Alonzo Trier. Shot from in close. No good. Randle to Gibson. Nothing going here on that drive. Count the bucket for two.
Contact on a drive can be a beautiful thing. Making those tough shots can really help you build a mental advantage over your defenders.
Quinn Cook, guarded by Gibson. And he's fouled. Very close, Jay. The results, he's going to the line.
Great job, Ed, by the shooter to create contact after the jump. That's how you get to the free throw line.
And hits the first free throw.
Number 13, Marcus Morris. And number 23.
Good free throw shooting. Knocks down a pair. Payton to Alonzo Trier. Count it. No and one. There was some contact there.
Strong finish. That's what you need, regardless of contact, focusing on the rim.
It's Cook with the basketball. Under a minute to go before halftime. Caldwell Pope. No, oh, had him going there for a second. Driving right to the basket. Five to shoot for Los Angeles. Has a chance. Shot by Caldwell Pope. No good. Oh, working hard there. Collects the rebound and gets it back up for the slam. The possession lies with New York. To Alonzo Trier. And he finishes at the rim.
And sometimes less is more. Keeping it simple is the best way.
Trying to cash in, cleans it up, and a putback slam. He was ready right at the tip.
What a first half he's having. He came out of the gate, attacked, found ways to get to the rim. Now look how easy the game is coming to him.
Step back. Deep three at the buzzer. That's it. First half has come to an end. The Lakers have the lead.
Halftime report. The Lakers will start the second half with a narrow lead. It was their playmaking, the way they gave each other scoring opportunities. That really impresses me. I love seeing unselfish basketball like that. These are the guys getting buckets
for the Los Angeles Lakers.
The Knicks are still very much in this matchup. And without question, they can put themselves in a position to win this game if they continue to rack up the assists. Have a look at the leading scores for the New York Knicks.
Game track. Bench points.
This is a game where the bench guys deserve a bit of the spotlight. The thing is, you need a spotlight big enough for the reserves on both squads. This is a game that's been all about the depth in the depth chart.
Player of the half.
Dwight Howard did a remarkable job of swatting shot after shot. Scorers have got to be thinking twice when he's within range.
Who was gold?
Every player that makes it to the NBA is a great athlete, but even the best players have off nights. Here we go with the top plays from the first half.
Number two. Number one.
And that concludes our halftime report. Thanks for joining us, and see you again after the game.
Flash at the controls. To Davis. Knocks it down off the step back.
Ed, I'm telling you right now, that is the move of an assassin.
LeBron into the front court. His guys lead here early stages third quarter. Able to convert inside.
It just seems like nobody can stop him but him. Once he's found his offensive swag, that boy's deadly.
Smith with it up top. His guys down three. Count it.
As my mother would say to the defender, A for effort, F for results.
Across the timeline comes James. Looking to make something happen. Kevin Knox. Good look that time, but off the mark.
And that's next level defense. The defender took away the pocket space of the shooter. Now, as a shooter, they shoot hundreds of shots each and every day from that pocket with consistency. Now you force them to change the angle or the positioning of that pocket, you're gonna lower the chances of them making that shot.
LBJ. To Howard. James. Here comes the screen. Oh, he had him there for a second. Dwayne Wade to Howard. 3 second count. Now preparing to shoot at the line.
I'm watching the coach's reaction right now, and I'll tell you, he's not going to be happy about that. The game comes down to the micro details. That wasn't a part of the plan right there.
Dennis Smith Jr. at the line for two shots. For his career, 69% at the line. Notched down the first. Two for two on that trip. LeBron into the front court. Down three. Here comes the screen. Here's LeBron for two. Knocks it down from mid-range.
When the ball is in his hands, we all knew what was going to happen.
New York Knicks basketball. Dennis Smith Jr. 4 out of 10.
Did you see the way that dribble freed him up? It created so much space. I did, but the defender didn't.
James, deep right corner. To Anthony, fires the three. That won't go. Smith, into the front court, up by three. Dwayne Wade, snatching it out of the air.
That kid can block out the sun, Ed.
Anthony. Short jumper stays out.
Hey, match up.
Drive here, but the shot stays out.
And you have to remember that your hand is part of the ball. There wasn't enough contact on that play for the refs to blow the whistle.
Yes, and the foul, and a chance at three coming up.
That was such a great job by the offensive player, knowing that you're probably going to take some lumps here and there, but still remaining aggressive throughout the shot and getting a crack at the extra point.
LeBron James at the line for a chance at a three-point play. For his career, 73%. And he's got the free throw as well. Possession lies with New York. Smith with a shot. It won't fall. James into the front court. Our score all even in this third quarter. Rises for the slam.
It's not every day that you see a 6'9", 265-pound freight train coming down the lane. You probably want to step out of the way.
Yes, and a foul. Hell of a chance at a three-point play.
And I know there's so much excitement about the play, but everybody looks at the player. More people need to pay attention to the guy at the end of the bench, the strength and conditioning coach, because this kid's been putting in the time and effort every day in the weight room.
Can't convert the free throw to Wade. And flushes it down. No stopping AD here. Good luck keeping up with that.
Did you see that jump? It was as quick as a pogo stick.
Into the front court comes Smith. His guys find themselves trailing by a bucket. Count the basket. Two more points in the paint.
Ed, 2 years ago, I was sitting in the draft room absolutely shocked that Dennis Smith went at 9 in the draft. And when I think about this young man's game, he is just scratching the surface of what he can do. He finished tied for 4th among rookies in scoring last season, and I guarantee you, his game is going to continuously go to different levels.
Converts in the paint. Nice finish at the rim.
Great job using that shoulder to create contact with the defender without hesitation.
Screen coming.
Stay coming.
Mitchell Robinson with a piece. Turnover gives them the possession. To Julius Randle. Kevin Knox. Nothing going here on that drive. Smith to Kevin Knox. Anthony Davis able to recover with the block.
Ed, that's light work for a guy with his ability.
He'll go to the foul line to shoot.
Ed, as a defender, you cannot, I repeat, you cannot foul in the act of upward motion into your shot. Your timing needs to be better.
Dwayne Wade has got two shots coming. For his career, 76% from the line. Off the mark on the first free throw. Good recovery. Hits the second free throw. Knicks with the basketball.
Hands up.
Oh, leaves the defender in the dust. Smith. Nothing going here on that drive. Ah, missed it. How'd that not go down?
It's because he took his eye off his target, Ed. As an offensive player, you have to glare at where the defender's coming to, but quickly redirect yourself to your actual target. He was more consumed with the defender than he was the actual rim.
And they call the foul. Not the breeze there, Jay.
He took a chance. That's the right call.
That's his first personal foul. Team foul number 3.
Smith shot, no good. Wade to James. Reggie Bullock sends it away. Dwayne Wade, 3 for 6 now.
This is a statement game for this unit. This defense has generated a lot of easy offense. And the one thing we know in the league, easy offense is hard to come by.
Leaves the defender in the dust.
got it.
No doubt about where that one was headed.
Lakers at the controls right now. Rondo guarded by Gibson. Missed it. They weren't going to give that to him. Another shot won't go either.
Because he had no body control. You have to be able to control your body when you attack the rim at full speed. That's part of your concentration. People assume concentration just on the rim, but your body control is everything. Be able to speed yourself up or slow yourself down.
Mitchell Robinson rejects it. That's his third block this evening.
Just incredible timing on that swat.
To James. Stuffs it down with authority.
These are missed opportunities. When a guy puts his head down, the help defender closest to the ball, you need to get your hand and scrape inside there. If he has his head down, he can't see you coming from the blind side.
Smith now into the front court. His guys now down by a point. The pass taken away by the Lakers.
You go back to the principles, things that we started working on when we were in first and second grade. It's called the shell drill. You stay down in the stance defensively, you try to deny the next pass away, and you have to communicate. If your conditioning is bad, you have no chance. But if you're able to do all these things together, collectively, you will be able to stop a great passing team.
And count the basket inside. Coach of the Knicks signals for a timeout as they'll discuss matters in what's now a three-point game. Changes coming from both sides right now.
Subbing in for the Los Angeles Lakers, number 15, Carmelo Anthony.
Smith on the drive, but his shot won't fall.
It's easy for the offense to get agitated when you keep turning around and the defense is right there in your face. The jawing is only going to escalate.
Smith with the basketball. The deficit now up to five. Goes reverse to lay it in.
I love the drive to the basket there. Instead of trying to go around or over, go through.
Los Angeles has the basketball. Caldwell Pope gets it in the left corner. Anthony picked up by Gibson. Not today. JaVale McGee goes to the right side. To Danny Green. Caldwell Pope. Marcus Morris the rebound. Alonzo Trier to Dennis Smith Jr. Has a look. The shot missed by Smith. To Caldwell Pope. And a putback slam.
Woo, that's nasty right there.
Smith with it up top. Less than a minute to go in this third quarter. Alonzo Trier to Dennis Smith Jr. Fires the three, and Dennis Smith Jr., he won't miss many of those, hits the wide open three.
And in today's game, you have to make shots like that. Nice work draining it from deep.
Caldwell Pope here against Taj Gibson. James to Danny Green. And that's going to get out of bounds. Off a Laker. Substitution being made in this one. Smith to Payton. Smith now. And McGee there for the rebound. Look out!
The assist from number one, Kentavious Caldwell-Pope. Let's go, pick him up.
Deep three, at the buzzer, Danny Green! Ah, tips it!
You know why? I don't see anybody on the defensive end standing up out of position. I see everybody squatted down, really active with their hands. That's the mentality that will lead you to where you want to go.
The Knicks to inbound here to start the fourth quarter. They trail to this point, but you'd have to say this one's up for grabs.
And the new style we play with in this league, all it takes is three quick threes, and you're right back in the ballgame.
To Dennis Smith Jr. Here comes the screen. In scores on the step back. Unguardable, Jay.
2 points. Take them any way you can get them.
To Wade, beyond the arc for three. Like the confidence, but a tough shot for Dwayne Wade. Smith, into the front court. His group now down two. To Marcus Morris. Baseline drive, Marcus Morris, strong finish.
Look at that, calm under pressure. You see a lot of guys rush those. Nice extra move there.
Lakers ball. James to Wade, sizing up the defense, Dwayne Wade, and the rebound taken in by Smith. In the front court comes Smith. Our score all even here in the fourth quarter. Doesn't have the touch, no good. Wade to James. Here comes the screen. Oh, mistake there as the pass stolen by the Knicks.
Tonight, it may not cost you, but in a playoff game, it will.
Oh, big finish at the rim.
Well, we got a chance to firsthand watch something be created. I think we just watched an epidemic of passing. I've never seen something like this before. It was so contagious, everybody started to do it, and it ultimately led to the other team's demise.
If that's an epidemic, sign me up. Oh, good defense by the Lakers. They come away with the steal. Kyle Kuzma won't go. Nice follow-up on the dunk there.
We're watching the clinic right now. We're watching basketball one-on-one. Whoever this professor is, he needs to get paid top dollar.
To Dennis Smith Jr. The pass taken away by the Lakers. Throws it up. Flushes down the slam. Jay, that's a strong connection.
And it's always about the play before the play. Look how the eyesight was able to connect between two players. We call that an eyesight contract. Because when you have a contract that's signed, sealed, and then delivered like that, that's how great plays are made.
Smith to Payton. Tough make through traffic.
But most importantly, you have to keep the ball moving. Maybe run some floppy sets, some horn sets. Raise those bigs up, which open up the lane, and let them be the passers to make plays easier for the guards.
Here comes the screen. Kuzma, guarded by Taj Gibson. He takes it right at them and scores. You have to fill in there.
Hey, look, pretty dudes can mix it up once in a while too, I guess.
Now the coach of the Knicks gonna signal for a timeout as they'll make sure they're all on the same page here in the fourth quarter.
And this is where I get a chance to see if coaches can change it up. Maybe let one of your players lead the timeout so your team can hear a different voice to keep everybody engaged. Maybe like the Warriors did with Andre Iguodala.
JaVale McGee, huge block.
Blocking so many shots only gives your perimeter that much more confidence to really apply more pressure.
Has a chance. Off the mark. With defense like that, little margin for error. Smith now, into the front court. The deficit is 6. Buries it on the catch and shoot.
Just because someone is listening to you doesn't mean that they actually hear you. At the end of the game, when players get tired, they listen to what the assignment was, but they didn't hear what it was.
Let's it fly from long range to Dennis Smith Jr. Layup goes down. Well done.
I don't know if the scouting report has made its way out here yet, but if anything, it says you need to not let him get that close to the rim.
McGee powers it through.
An easy two. Get back on defense.
Number two.
Let's see what the Knicks can do here. A lot of contact on that play. He plays through it and scores.
That might have been a little bit easier than expected there, considering the score.
To Kyle Kuzma. Nice pace, sets it up, and slams it down.
It's that easy, Ed. You never want to leave any doubt when attacking the rim.
Smith with the basketball. His guy's down 3. Oh, good defense by the Lakers. They come away with the steal. Dennis Smith Jr. sends it away.
Continuous effort is the key for your team's success. No one this entire ballgame has quit on a play. That right there, that's what's going to help your team win this game.
Kuzma trying to cash in. He's too good to leave that wide open. Defense has to communicate. Jay, mixed opinions with Carmelo Anthony. How will you remember his career?
Well, as of right now, he's a catch-and-shoot type player. But for me personally, Carmelo Anthony will go down as one of the greatest isolation players of all time. Back in his Denver days, his earlier New York Knicks days, there was nobody better in an isolated set than CA.
Alonzo Trier has a look. Oh, it can't connect. Los Angeles, they have it. To Anthony. Surveys the floor. Anthony. Almost unlucky bounce. Kevin Knox to Dennis Smith Jr. Nothing going here on that drive. It was right there. Kevin Knox to Julius Randle. Big finish that time for Julius Randle.
If you didn't dunk that, then we would have to talk about it.
Number 20.
To Wade. Here comes the screen. Dwayne Wade. Julius Randle with the block.
This game is all about playing mind tricks on people. The offense is more worried about getting their shot blocked than they are about actually making the shot.
Dwight Howard into the game for the New York Knicks. Number 67, Taj Gibson.
Oh, 5-second violation. Smith with it up top. They're down 3. To Alonzo Trier. Down to Randle. And stuffs it home. Whoa, he got up there.
Just showing you that 40-inch vertical.
Lakers at the controls right now. Quinn Cook here against Taj Gibson. Can't connect from inside. Smith into the front court. His guys now trailing by a point. To Taj Gibson. Finishes strong.
And when you get your prescription, you take your medicine and you call it a day.
Cook to bring it into the front court. He'll run the offense. To Howard. Cruises inside for 2.
This may sound cheesy, but sometimes you just need to sit back, get a tub of popcorn, and just enjoy the show because that's what you're watching right now.
Dennis Smith Jr. defended by Quinn Cook. Oh, they call him for the foul.
Ed, you can't lunge like that.
Some lineup changes now for both clubs.
Stepping in for the Los Angeles Lakers,
Smith to the basket, but it stays out. Oh, and a pass stolen by the Knicks. Won't go down. New York in control of the basketball. Old school. Backs his man for the basket.
Ed, I have so much admiration for guys that continue to hunt their shot. They're playing the second half like it was the first 5 minutes of the ball game. Those natural born leaders are guys that will consistently lead your team to the promised land.
How you practice leads to that. Nice pump fake.
The defender needs to do a better job of forcing a pickup there.
To Dennis Smith Jr. And the Lakers with the rebound. Finishing inside the paint on that one.
And did you see the lift on the shot? Did you see the ball release off the hand? To be able to have the concentration to finish with such a feathery touch in the midst of contact.
Got a piece of it.
Jumping out the gym right now, Ed.
Great anticipation. Into the front court comes Rondo. Leads three. Yes, Carmelo Anthony. Now 3 for 9.
And Melo will be the first one to tell you this. He's not ready to be a role player just yet. He can still put up points in bunches. Didn't shoot the ball that well last year, averaged around 16 a game, the lowest total of his 15-year career.
Wow. Offensive board. Offensive board. And he's going to the line to shoot.
I've seen it happen so many times. Small things like that foul can end up becoming a momentum changer. Let's see how this one plays out.
Misses the first. Second one's good. Splits the pair. Timeout here for the Knicks. It's their first of the final 3 minutes. That leaves them with one more chance to stop the clock before the buzzer sounds. Time to shuffle things up. Smith. Dwight Howard swats it. It's Wade. Yes, and the foul, and a chance at three coming up.
And so many players, when they come into the paint, they come in with that soft approach. He didn't come in soft at all. He came in with aggression, and he went through the defender. Through, not around. That's key.
Dwayne Wade trying to cash in on the three-point play, shooting 50%, some yes, some no, in this contest. And he can't convert the free throw. Cashes in. Someone has to get into a zip code.
Every NBA player has a superpower. His, obviously, is that depth perception, because that trajectory leads the ball to the net every time.
Finish that. 17-footer at the buzzer. The Lakers get the victory as they get a good win on the road. That does it. For my partner Jay Williams and our entire crew, I'm Ed Cohen. This has been a presentation of the NBA on EA Sports. For more, log on to easports.com. As we say, so long, everyone.
is Jalen Rose, and it's time for the EA Sports post-game wrap-up. The Lakers emerged victorious after a tight finish. I could get into detail about their play calling and shot selection, but let's be honest. We all know that the dunks were the most exciting. I'd be surprised if the rim isn't a little bit bent at this point. Check out the leading scores for the Los Angeles Lakers. The Knicks finished on the losing end of a close score. They did a great job with their ball movement, forcing the defense to constantly make adjustments. Unfortunately, it wasn't enough for the win. Check out the leading scores for the New York Knicks.
Game tracking. Assists.
You can tell both of these teams feel very comfortable in their offensive system. There was plenty of great playmaking in this contest.
Player of the game.
LeBron James seemed to think he could only score points with dunks in this game. Again and again, he kept throwing them down, and it was just astonishing. These are the top plays of the game.
Number two. Number one.
These are the upcoming matchups for the New York Knicks. This has been a presentation of ESPN on EA Sports. Until next time, I'm Jalen Rose, signing out.